top heroine, Lord, returns with a sunny introduction to a new era on Solar Power, the first single from her upcoming album of the same name.
Forget all of the tears that you've cried, it's over.
The upbeat cut opens with a declaration of dislike for winter weather. Despite her lamentations on the cold, the New Zealand singer took a trip to Antarctica to learn about the climate crisis back in February 2019.
I hate the winter, can't stand the cold, I tend to cancel all the plans.
It can be so overwhelming emotionally and just getting at it from a different perspective. I think Antarctica is a really good metaphor for that. Like, it doesn't feel doomy when you're down there. I felt an incredible amount of hope.
In the next breath, she notes the invitation of summer with a nod to A Tribe Called Quest's iconic track, Can I Kick It?
But when the heat comes, something takes a hold. Can I kick it? Yeah, I can.
Can I kick it?
Yes, you can.
Can I kick it?
Yes, you can.
Well, I'm gone.
Back on the track, she compares her artist moniker to Jesus Christ.
The boys and girls onto the beaches. Come on, come all, tell you my secrets. I'm kinda like a prettier Jesus.
To round out her verse, the elusive pop star winks at her lack of presence in recent years. Her Instagram only features three photos with her last image posted on April 5th, 2018.
And I throw my cellular device in the water. Can you reach me? No.
I'm not really on the internet now, which is great. I love that for me. You know me, I go like full hibernation.
The final chorus draws us into the healing nature of the sun. Keeping with the theme, the track's release coincided with 2021's only solar eclipse appearing on streaming services on June 10th at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Turn it on in a new kind of bright, it's solar.
The track's outro features a chorus of Solar Powers with background vocals from Phoebe Bridgers and upcomer Clara. The outro reminds me a bit of the late George Michael's Freedom.
Freedom!
With a dash of Aquarius from the 70s musical Hair,
and Jupiter,
but ends with a vocal distortion reminiscent of Sober 2 off her 2017 album Melodrama, which points to the power of pop music. Solar Power comes after a four-year hiatus following her critically acclaimed album, Melodrama. The track takes a different tone from the lovelorn tracklist of her last album, and fans can expect a different energy from the New Zealander.
Well, this one just felt like the perfect first chapter for this album. It's about that, like, infectious kind of flirtatious energy that starts to come, the magic of the sun and of nature. I just thought it was a really cool, like, light, cute, fun, zany place to start.
The track was produced by Lord and frequent collaborator Jack Antonoff, lead singer of Bleachers and pop guru who has lent a helping hand to pop stars like Taylor Swift. The pair worked together for Melodrama and created a career-defining sound for the pop star.
Every sound in that is handpicked by us and you know, right up to like, we had the mix and we were getting in the mix and mixing it ourselves. Like, it was just such a kind of, we were right in there, which is fun.
The music video, directed by Joel Kofali and Lord herself, is set on a dreamlike oasis with Lord serving as the sun in a bright yellow fit amongst the tonal threads of the rest of the characters. Throughout the visual, she prances around the beach, leads her people in a spiritual awakening, and takes a symbolic hit out of a bong made of fennel, a quirky moment which is expected from the enigmatic artist.
This video is kind of like me introducing you to the world of the album and the videos, and I kind of play like a kooky tour guide almost.
Since the track's release, the song has jumped to the top of the Genius Top Song charts, and fans can't wait for the rest of the album's release. If you want to learn more about Solar Power, check out the song page on Genius.com. I'm Delisa with Genius News, bringing you the meaning and the knowledge behind the music.